Hi everyone! In this video, I will speak about accuracy of 3D printed parts. So, let's say if I have 9.6 millimeters in my drawing, I would like to produce my part as close to this dimension as possible. This is especially important for functional parts which interact with each other. As you know, there are many reasons for deviation of dimensions between CAD model and 3D printed part, like material shrinkage, printer calibration, and so on. So, if you manage to 3D print your part with suitable tolerances on one printer, well, this may require a bit of testing. It may not work on another printer. This is however understandable. It's simply a different hardware. But surprisingly, even when you work with one single 3D printer, it quite depends on location where the part is printed on the heated bed. So I got an idea to have a look on this phenomenon and characterize my 3D printer in terms of spatial accuracy distribution over my heated bed. First, I made this model. We have 5 times 5 cubes equally distributed on XY plane. First finding is that in spite of the fact that U20 AlfaWise printing area is 300 times 300 millimeters, I cannot import my model with those dimensions into Cura software. So I decided to scale the model with factor 0.95 to fit. In this case, the cube external dimensions are 19 times 19 millimeters, cube internal dimensions are 9.5 times 9.5 millimeters. Depth of the square hole is 19 millimeters. The XY dimensions of the whole model are 285 times 285 millimeters. So the part is printed with standard settings provided by Cura software for U20 AlfaWise. Material is PLA. The part itself looks like this. The next step is to measure dimensions of each cube and calculate percent error. The true value is the one indicated in CAD drawing. If we insert the values, we get our percent error. If the part is, for example, larger than its nominal dimensions, the result will be a positive number. With this procedure, we get percent error for each dimension of each cube. Here we have results for external cube dimension in X direction. Next, I wrote a short code in SILAB in order to post-process, or better, interpolate data. SILAB is a very user-friendly freeware software, really good for such kind of things. From this image, we can see that I should rather avoid printing on the left side of the heated bed. Here we go with other results. Percent error for external cube size in Y direction. In the left side. In the right side is percent error of the hole depth dimension. Hole is then deeper with respect to nominal value. Here we have percent error for cube inner hole dimensions in X and Y direction. We surprisingly see that depending on location, the dimension is either smaller or larger with respect to nominal value. Again, I should avoid printing on the left side of the heated bed. What are the global conclusions? Avoid edges of the bed for printing of precise parts. Use the same location of the bed for the best reproducibility of your parts. The methodology outlined here can be used for diagnosis of your printer. And I would be very interested what you get with your device, with Prusa or Flux Delta Plus. So please let me know. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.